Hi friends, let's start with our series of solving hacker rank practice problem. Today I'm gonna solve Messiah name. I could not pronounce French, so just forgive me for the mistake of pronunciation. But it belongs to the algorithm section, and in the algorithm section it belongs to the game theory problem. So basically it says that two players are playing a game of Messiah name. The basic rule of the game are as follows. The game starts with n pile of stones indexed from 0 to n minus 1. Each pile I, where 0 less than equal to I and I should be greater than n, has S1 stored. The player move in alternating turns. During each move, the current player must remove one or more stones from a single pile. The player who moves the last stone loses the game. So basically here it's basically again a new kind of problem. So you have to figure out the solution. But unlike the last problem, here the person who makes the last move loses the game. In the last time what was happening was that the person who is unable to make a move was losing the game. So basically here we will be using a function. First we will write a very important import function. So basically functools is an inbuilt function. Okay, so that's the reason in Python language you'd automatically able to use that. But some other packages like TensorFlow, NumPy are not inbuilt functions. So those type of things you won't be able to use in your competitive programming. So you have to just check it out which type of packages are supported by your current IDE in which you are coding in competitive programming. So basically, generally the inbuilt functions are generally allowed. But in some special cases, like in some other competitive coding also, I've seen NumPy or Pandas been allowed. So you have to check that out. So I will write my code. So basically it's again based on observation rather than coding stuff. So it's basically based on some theoretical knowledge. I will also share you with those resources from where you could understand the theoretical concepts and how to solve this type of problem. So I'll be using a reduce function. I will explain you what reduce function is and how is that necessary. We could also use the for loop here. It would have done basically the same thing, but let's use some interesting more advanced function so that you would be able to understand how these are done. First, so first let me explain what this the reduce function does. So basically reduce function is for if it is basically doing a looping. Okay, so it's basically doing a loop for our array, I guess s, for our array s it is doing a loop and it is performing XOR functions and it is storing the result. as you could see, it's able to successfully pass all the test cases. And basically, I will explain you the what the reduce function basically is. The reduce function is used to apply a particular function past argument to all the list of element. Or I could just copy and paste. I would also suggest you to go and check some tutorials on reduce function, how it operates, because to explain to reduce function is not a part of this explanation, but a reduce function is quite a fascinating. It reduces the problem or the complexity. And also I would suggest you to read one more thing, which is also going to provide you how lim function operates. So basically it is an Wikipedia link. You'd able to understand why we are performing XOR operations to get the output. So that's the basic idea. Stay tuned for the next video, and thanks for watching.